Hello everyone, welcome to another class 11 math class. Today we'll discuss about the practical problems of union and intersection. Okay, so you know that whenever the first condition, whenever A intersection B is phi, then n of the number of elements actually of A union B will give n of A plus n of B. Simply, whenever A intersection B is phi, that means there is no common element of A and B, then number of elements of A union B means n of A plus n of B, that means number of elements of A plus number of elements of B. This is the trivial case, but in case where A intersection B not equal to phi, in this case, that means there are some elements of A intersection B, that means A intersection B contains some elements, then number of elements n of A union B equals to n of A plus n of B minus n of A intersection B. Okay, so from the Venn diagram I am showing in the previous class that A union B can be written in the union of three disjoint sets. A union B can be written in the union form of three disjoint sets. So, A union B means A minus B union A intersection B union B minus A. Now, n of A union B equals to the number of elements in A minus B plus n of A intersection B plus n of B minus A. Okay? We have to show that n of A union B equals to n of A plus n of B minus n of A intersection B. Now, n of A minus B plus n of A intersection B, this is one portion, plus n of B minus A plus n of A intersection B. I am writing this portion extra, so I have to adjust it by minus n of A intersection B. Now, this portion within the third bracket, you can see this is actually n of A. Why? Because n of A minus B means that this portion is added with the n of A intersection B, with the common portion. So, it gives n of A, and the second portion within the third bracket similarly will give n of B. So, we get n of A plus n of B, and this portion is left here minus n of A intersection B. So, n of A union B finally gives n of A plus n of B minus n of A intersection B. Okay. Now, I am solving one problem with this property. Exercise number 1.6, question number 3, just go through the question with me. In a group of 400 people, 250 can speak Hindi, 200 can speak English, how many people can speak both Hindi and English? So, in a group of 400 people, so actually here n of H union E. What is H? H is a set of people who can speak English, who can speak Hindi. Bigger pardon, H equals set of people who can speak Hindi. And the E means the set of people who can speak English. So here the total number of people is 400. So, n of H union E equals to 400, first of all. Second of all, 250 can speak Hindi. So, n of H equal to 250. 200 can speak English. N of E equals to 200. Now you have to find how many people can speak both Hindi and English. So you have to find N of H intersection E. This is the practical problem of union of intersection actually. You have to find the how many people can speak Hindi and English. So from the formula we have proved earlier, we can write N of H union E equals to N of H plus N of E minus N of H intersection E. Now put the values here, 400 equal to 250 plus 200 minus N of H intersection E. Therefore, N of H intersection E equals to 450 minus 400, which gives 50. So, N of H intersection E equals to 50. So, 50 people can speak both English and Hindi. Now, you are trying to solve the next problems 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 in your home. Okay. In the next class, we will solve some problems of the miscellaneous. Okay. Thank you for today.